Good evening, everyone. I am Kajol from NIT Patna, and I am presenting before you implementation of discussion navigation. Earlier, the information about the engagement of students and the discussion forum were not available to EDX Analytics Dashboard, which is basically an idea used by the instructor to find the engagement of the students in their courses. So, here is a short demo regarding the work we have done.
Good afternoon to all. Here I am going to give you a demo of discussion navigation that we have added in our insights dashboard. So before I proceed, I would like to tell you we have created an API to retrieve data from backends. For example, these are the APIs that EDX and they use it to retrieve data from backends. So we have developed APIs.
Okay, these are the APIs that are pre-installed by EDX and they use to retrieve data from backends. So you can see that we have developed two APIs, new discussion participation and discussion contributed to retrieve data from backend. So we have to provide a course ID for which we want to retrieve data. For example, here I'm going to paste a course ID for which I have data. I got an error of the authentication of credentials were not provided because I haven't provided an EDX API key. Let's check it out. So you can see that I got some data. Here I got some title and number of contributed and number of views. For which, for example, I have a title and corresponding to the number of contributed and number of views. That in our discussion form. For example, for this particular title, I have number of contributed equal to 10 and number of viewed equal to 200. And similarly for contributed, I'll retrieve data from backend. For same course, you can see that the number of upload 272. That means the number of students who uploaded any data corresponding to that course ID in a discussion form. These API will integrate in our discussion tab that we have created in our discussion form. Yes, ma'am. This data is got from Spark program. So here I'm going to enter the login credentials. And corresponding password. And sign in. This is the EDX Insights, EDX dashboard. Here I'm going to choose a particular course for which I want to retrieve data. I'm instructor, so I will go to instructor tab. So we have added our discussion navigation in our insights site. So I have to redirect to insights site. So here I will click on. So you can see that here are four navigations. We have created our discussion navigation in engagement. You can access from here or we can access from directly through there. So this is the navigation, discussion navigation that we have added. And we have plotted the corresponding graph that we have retrieved data. This is the title and the corresponding viewed that we have retrieving data from backend from our APIs. For example, this is our title and corresponding viewed are 48,610. And similarly for contribution, the number of contributed people for this title. Also, we have retrieved data of number of people who uploaded any data corresponding to this ID. Also, we have displayed the data in tabular form as insights do. You can download this data as in CSV format. Let it open. You can see that this is the same data that we have plotted over and showed there on tabular form.
Very good afternoon, everyone. So we have set up the Hadoop multinode cluster. We have took three slaves and one master. And then we set up the Hive, then Scoop, and Apache Spark. So after receiving the data from the parser group, which we receive in MySQL tables, we run some, use the scoop and transfer the data into HDFS. Then from there, we run some Spark tags, and we did some analytics to answer some of the top five questions, which were not earlier there. So the first question was this, the top 10 comments. For my reference, I have taken the course CS101.1x, and we have plotted the graph about the top 10 comments. So as you can see that blame plus paddy field problem, this is the most important comments in CS101.1x. So this comment can be useful to the instructor, so that when instructor will get the idea that these comments are discussed among the students, so in these future videos or in future lectures, he can include the a brief more idea about the comments. The next question was the number of questions versus the number of discussion. And for this, I have again used the same course, that is CS101.1x. So as you can see, for this course, the number of questions were around 57%, while discussion was 43%. So this will give the idea to the instructor that since there are more questions, so maybe the students are not clear about this certain topics. And so in the next question, I've tried to find out these questions. So these were the top 20 to 30 questions. Unanswered questions about the CS101.
There's a note gone to Dr. Fatak. Please go back to the earlier slide. Okay. That students have doubt regarding your subject. Have you sent a note to him?
Sir?
Your inference has been communicated to the faculty.
We have used only few.
What?
We have used a sample of the log files.
Why?
We got around nearly 60 GB of data we collected from the IIT Bombay. Then we did the parsing and all. Then for our reference, just we took the sample of the data.
What I'm saying is, you people are claiming analytics very important. I don't believe it, but forget it. This, no, we don't want that discussion. Okay. And then you are saying that people who believe so robustly analytics and has spent 8 weeks on it, okay, on working, on answering questions which are not there, the result of the question has not been communicated to the faculty?
This is the experimental.
Then I don't want to see experimental value. I want to see actual results, no?
The same, we can use the code. Our code will...
In a presentation at the end of your thing, you are saying that one single course also you are not passed through. Fully. Why? So what was stopping them 8 weeks?
Sir, from the starting we need...
No. Even if we take 4 days to crunch, why have you not crunched? You are not crunching, no? ऐसा तुमको काम नहीं करना है ना? मशीन क्रंच कर रहा है ना? चार चलने दो चार दिन. मैं you have got 8 weeks and you don't take one full course. I don't get any output of your thing. Okay? How much I fired my poor library guy for not doing work and giving completion? The same thing is true with you people. No. Same thing is true with these people. Okay. You have to produce for one course at least. Okay. Take all the data and run it. Which one of you is there for one more week? There is one person, correct? So, you are there, he is there for one more week. Take one course, let us see whether Dr. Fatak's course questions are more or discussions are more or whatever it is. Okay. Ek to complete karo. जैसा मैंने उनको बोला एक तो कंप्लीट करो मशीन को काम करना है तुमको नहीं काम करना है सैंपल डेटा इज नॉट करेक्ट वी कैन नॉट बिलीव दैट योर सॉफ्टवेयर इज वर्किंग अनलेस यू कंप्लीट वन कोर्स वो बीच में तुम बोलेगा सब लॉक खराश हो गया मेरा पार्सल मर गया दैट यू हैव टू नो ना वन डेटा यू हैव टू डू
सो अगेन वी ट्राई टू फाइंड द मोस्ट व्यूड कमेंट्स एंड अगेन वी यूज द सेम कोर्स दैट इज CS101.1x
बेसिकली मोस्ट व्यूड कमेंट्स Okay, I need to know if there is an outlier. Okay, if I run it on the full course, okay, if all the there should be some comments which are way above and something where which is way below. Most of them average I don't want to see. The reason for running a full course is when I do an analytics, I have to only concentrate on outliers as a faculty. I need to know what are the outliers. And if there are no outliers, everywhere it is same within a range of say plus or minus 10%, then that data is useless. It doesn't get me anything. Okay. That is why it is necessary to run it on the full course. Okay. Your analytics, you don't run every day, you run it at the end of the course. No, some feedback has to be there. Okay. Basically, something that, what is the valuable feedback that a faculty can get? You people should put it in your project report. Okay.
Good evening, everyone. I am Manshu. I will talk about Jenkins. Jenkins is a powerful open source application that allows continuous integration and build automation regardless of the platform which we are using. It is used to build and test the system automatically. When someone commits their changes, it integrates the system automatically. And if there is an error, that error can be sent to a person by a notification. Now, after installing, we should configure Jenkins. Security must be enabled, and path of a Java home and Git should be given. Transferring tracking logs to HDFS. No. We have to install Hadoop on a server in which Jenkins is running. It is a Jenkins scheduler which will transfer. Every day, new log files has been created and stored in a remote server. So these log files should be transferred to the HDFS in a local server, so that we can run analytics task on that. So why we use Jenkins is we should automate this task so that it can run every day at midnight and transfer the tracking log from the remote server to the HDFS on a local machine. So these are the, I cannot show the demo because there is no LANware and I have to access the...
Very simple question.
There is a course running on the production server right now. Okay. Correct. Why is your system not used to test that course? And secondly, if you are saying that I will download data every day...
I will transfer the data to HDFS every day.
Doesn't matter. Every day you are doing some activity, correct?
Yeah, it is done automatically.
Yeah. You, through the agent called Jenkins, is doing something, yeah, correct? Yeah. Every day. Okay. Does the faculty know that you are doing it every day? First of all, why are you doing it every day? Why not at the end of the course? I assume you are doing it every day because you want to have current data. So current data and the current analysis, can you not use Jenkins, okay, to run her program, that program, at the end of the day, early morning, 6 o'clock, Indian time, not US time. Faculty gets a report of the analysis tool. Why not?
So, correct.
So, I'm asking, currently, is Dr. Phatak getting a report every day?
No.
Then, he's not doing. What are you saying he's doing?
Work in progress.
Nothing, no work in progress. He is downloading data every day. That person's whatever question that he is answering every day. The only thing is you are not reporting to Dr. Phatak. Because you are probably, I don't know whether, are you running it on IIT Bombay X production data?
No, it has been run on EDX platform.
On?
EDX platform.
What EDX platform? Which course are you taking downloading data every day?
Tracking logs are from IIT Bombay X, CSCS 101.
CS101, as far as I know, is not running every day, no? Is it a running course now? No. What is he doing every day is my question. The only course which I think is running is Dr. Phatak's course, which is something else, learning technology or something like that. That is the course that is running on IIT Bombay X.
The log files which we get every day, it will transfer them to HDFS.
But are you monitoring the current course that is running?
No, I am not.
Then what are you monitoring every day? There is one course which is running, you are not monitoring that.
These are not according to production, that we are talking about the production. This is what we are doing
the development. But he says it's implemented. I cannot show you a demo, is all he said.
I can show.
No, but what have you tested? Why have you not tested? I don't understand. Why have you not tested on real live production data?
Because I didn't.
But why they are not doing it?
The operation people have to give the access.
No. What operation people have to give the access?
Your server has to be running. Whatever you have done is offline. You have made it from the log file and
have... No. So are you saying that the IIT Bombay does not have access to the S3 server every day?
No.
If that is true, then there is no point in developing anything.
Using REST server,
will we increase our local Hadoop file system? That's what you're saying. Yeah, but you are taking the data from S3 and loading the local Hadoop file server, no? Yeah, but IIT Bombay X is producing data on the Amazon S3, correct? Does Dr. Phatak, does he have the authority to download data every day? That is in the question number one. He has, then why are you not using it? So you are downloading data, data can only come from S3. There is S3, you have got this big parser of yours, which is taking data and storing it, that water pipeline you said. So that is being stored in local Hadoop. Then why it is not being used? But then on what you have tested? If you are not testing production data, on what have you tested this? But on sample log files, you can't have everyday data, no?
I generally put data on that reboot server.
Production data is available. Okay, you are not causing any damage. Okay, I'll ask another question. Is Dr. Phatak prevented from accessing the data more than once? Ye baba main soch sakta hu tumne nahi liya. Okay, ki baba ek baar hai Dr. Phatak ka ek gaya to fir Dr. Phatak ka data jayega.
Give us the permission to show the permission.
Have you asked, show me the documentary mail? Okay, show me a mail. I want to know if required data and Dr. Phatak is not adversely impacted. Who is stopping it?
We have to first test it every day. We have to do the production data. So there are lot of other things
to do. No, that is exactly what I am saying. No. Mrs. Nag, I did not say that. I am saying, are you causing any harm by pulling data from S3? If you are not causing any harm, why have you not pulled? Your software may not work. You will destroy the data every day. What is the problem? Okay. Your software not working is perfectly fine. I am just talking about test data which is available, large amount of test data which is available. I can have performance testing on your software. I can know whether her code requires 48 hours to run or his code runs in 48 seconds. All that valid information is lost because you refuse to use data.
Well, we can make the data available as open source for others also.
Next, I will call Ipshita for conclusions.
Moving over to the future work, as of now only two tasks have been converted from MapReduce to PySpark. What can be done in the future is this can be extended to the entire enrollment section. And
there is one thing which is absent in the future. I think you should add it. Okay. Run it on actual production server data. Why it is not there? That is future work.
Why you are taking future work when you are closing your internship?
The event catching mechanism can be made better, and now in the discussion menu we are showing only one graph, so similarly whatever queries we have answered that can be integrated. Pratik will continue.
Moving on, the LMS to HDFS transfer can be made avoided through a temporary storage. This is making the system inefficient. One more idea that we had was that we could apply machine learning techniques to draw meaningful conclusions from the comments on a discussion forum. Also, our parser can be optimized by reordering the data. Also, in the end, we would like to thank our lovely mentor, Mr. Shukla Nag, for a constant support and encouragement. We would also like to thank Avinash Awate sir and Dr. D.B. Phatak sir for this wonderful program.
I want to tell all of you one thing, okay? Part of the thing here is, as somebody said, learning industry grade, okay? This is college grade. Industry grade means you have to test with whatever opportunity. Okay, testing is the most important thing. My people know that. I've been hammering them on testing. Okay, for the rest of you, testing. Your software only as good as it is tested. Okay, otherwise it is college software. Okay, You can walk through any interview, okay, any interview. Okay, if the person knows that you write tested software, okay, because that is the differentiator between a college level software and industry software. Okay. Only because what TCS lies writes all kinds of junk. Okay. Absolutely all kinds. Okay. Hopefully she's still around. Okay. But it is tested. Okay. And I believe in TCS testing. At least at my time they were actually testing, and only junk software was junk, but testers will catch it. Okay. That's the only difference.